Welcome to another Mike Glavin exciting bike build video. We're getting started with another one. I'm sure you will find this video as provocative and enlightening as the Lisa bike build, although I find this bike a lot more exciting because it's for me. First step, as always, which I usually do here in the TV room, is building up the wheels. I'll take you through these parts this time. These are Velocity Synergy wheels, both of them asymmetrical, which is the custom for all the wheels I build. If you watch these videos, you'd know. And then these wheels are kind of special because they're designed as a rim brake compatible rim, but you can get them specially non-machined, so the rims will be black all the way. So they're disc rims, since these are disc wheels, even though they're for a road bike. Both the, because they are disc wheels, both rims are asymmetrical, not just the rear one. Also, for the first time ever, one exciting thing about these asymmetrical rims is that every spoke, front and back, on this bike is 292 millimeters long. Left, right, front, back, which is pretty cool. The asymmetrical rims make up for the offset, and they should be run at pretty even tension as well. So I think that's pretty cool. They'll all be, and you can see I got a bag of 50, and then I got some extra ones. I'm going to use some silver ones on either side of the valve stem hole. I'm using Wheelsmith spokes this time around, which are butted down to 1.7 millimeters in the center. A little bit thinner, a little bit lighter than the DT spokes I've used. I've heard really good things about them. And just looking at them, I can tell the quality of these, I think, in general, is better than what I'm getting out of DT. And there's also a rant that a guy did in New Hampshire talking about something about these elbows here, which I didn't understand. But so, Wheelsmith spokes, double butted, 2 millimeters, 1.7 millimeters, and then, as always, brass nipples. And I'm going to use mostly black brass nipples and then silver nipples on the four spokes that are going to run on either side of the valve stem. Instead of rim tape, I have rim tape here, but I'm not going to use it this time. I'm going to use these funky little, much lighter than rim tape, little plugs. And then if you ever need to access one of the spokes, you can just pop the plug out and you don't need to pull the whole strip off the rim. And those are made by Velocity and designed to fit their eyelided rims. They have another color for non-eyelided rims. Skewers are going to be Salsa flip-offs, just like I've used on my mountain bike in red. And the hubs, the highlight of the build, are the glorious Chris King hubs. So we'll lace these things up, let you see what they look like before we start tensioning. Here's one of my little secrets. I always prep the end of every spoke. Takes a long time, actually, with a Wheelsmith spoke prep. There's usually two different colors, but since all of my spokes are 272 millimeters, no need to color code them. They can all go anywhere on both wheels. Now, both wheels have been assembled, but not tensioned, so not built at all, but put together. And you might be able to see that the two spokes on either side of the valve stem hole here are silver. And it's hard to see in this light. All the rest of them are black. That gives it a little bling. And then you can see the rear wheel, the rim is offset to the right. The disc rotor will be on that side, and the cassette will be on that side. And then on the front wheel, it's offset to the left. The disc rotor will be on this side, and you can see the rim is offset to the left. So both wheels are, even the front wheel, because of the disc, are not dished equally. But the magic of these wheels is that by taking the rim and offsetting it to the left on the front wheel, actually to the right on the front wheel and to the left on the rear wheel, all the spokes are the exact same length, which means when I tension, I should be able to get equal tension on both sides, which is the beauty of this wheel set. Somebody else also asked me how I go about the build. What I usually do, and you might be able to see this, it's not going to focus. So I get down to about 2 threads each showing on every one of them after assembly. Then I tension the whole wheel just to the lightest possible tension that I can get a reading on my tensometer. Then I go all the way around and make sure the tension on every single spoke is equal. Then I true, then I equalize the tension again, then I true, and I do it till it's absolutely true and tensioned at really low tension, but a tension I can read with my tensometer, and then I just ratchet up the tension and check trueness as I go up. And I find that that gives me the easiest and best build. So the next step here is to tension and true these wheels and do the actual wheel build. I've taken the frame to the bike shop and had the headset cups pressed in. I don't have a tool for that. They face the head tube, and they've also chased the bottom bracket, the paint out of there, but not face the bottom bracket because there's external cups. So you just leave the paint right on the face there and it'll keep it from rusting. Also, to keep it from rusting, I'm about to apply frame saver to the inside of all the tubes where obviously there's no paint to prevent rust of the steel frame. I'm going to do this twice. All right, I've built up both the wheels. Here's the back one. And I did want to show you, instead of rim strip, I'm using these funky, I don't know if I'm getting a good shot of it, these funky plugs that are made by Velocity, and they just press into each one of the holes, and they're lighter than rim strip, and if you have a problem with one of the spokes, you can pry the little plug out of there, do what you need to do with that nipple, replace it or whatever, and then put the plug back in, and no goo, so they just pressed in there, press fit in. Really cool. When I tensioned the wheels, there was only about a quarter turn more tension on one side or the other on the front wheel, and maybe half a turn more tension on one side of the wheel than the other for the rear wheel. So by far, the most even tension I've had on offset wheels like this in any set of wheels I've built. So I'm pretty happy how they've turned out so far. Okay, I'm out in the now semi-finished secret room. As you can see, the walls are painted, but still got stuff piled up all the way around. But finally I have light. It's dark out, but I can see outside through my window now. It's not such a bunker. That thing down there is my heat. And here are all the parts for the builds since I last saw you. I filled all these tubes with frame saver, which is a stuff that goes down to the tube to keep steel from rusting. So it's fully protected, ready to build. The wheels are sitting over here on the ground, ready to go. The only part that I've ordered that's not here for the bike is the tires. So I have to put on old tires, which is fine because I have really good tires out here. Because I'm running studs on the Surly upstairs. I'll just run my summer tires on this till I get my new Schwalbe Marathon tires. First step is to finish up these wheels. So I'm going to put the rotors on first. I put a little bit of grease on the end of each one of the rotor bolts. Put it in there, torque to spec. Now in the rear wheel, I'll put on the cassette, which is a SRAM PG1070. It's basically a SRAM rival cassette. 11 tooth small cog, and a whopping 32 big cog, like a mountain bike cassette.